Almost done. Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren. Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
How do you get locked in a room?
Victoria is not nice. I don't get it. She has everything. And to pull that prank on a friend?
Just because they're in the Vortex Club doesn't mean they're BFFs. I'm in it, and Victoria creeps me out. Max, you're smart to be a loner here. Though Warren obviously likes hanging with you.
He's a good guy. A geek like me.
You saw the files in his flash drive. Tons of crazy shit. Films I've never even heard of. And in a special folder called Max.
Yeah, okay. I gotcha.
Are you blushing? Go ahead and grab the flash drive whenever.
She's telling me to, she's trying to kick me out? I think she's trying to kick me out.
This is both sad and pathetic.
It's like a writing, but I thought I should write this to you. You might not hate my dumb ass forever. I can't read. I know I act like a tough jock around everybody. But I act right around, blah, 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 blah. Needing money, blah, blah, blah. Logan. Oh, hello.
That looks like a home pregnancy test.
It's just mine. Why would you take that?
Max, that's mine. Thank you.
Are you pregnant?
You're not helpful. You're just nosy. I think you better go.
Let me get that rewind action real quick, though. Hold up.
Nice, Max. You hurt her feelings by being so damn nosy again. But I could rewind and make it up to her.
It was popping.
Now I feel too wiped out to leave.
La la la, I don't see that pregnancy test.
Give me my flash.
Protect my precious so Max never has to chase it down again.
She didn't just do that. Ew, USB 2.
Of course a popular cheerleader like Dana would have a million friends. It's so fascinating to get a peek into Dana's social media world.
And all right, I'm going to use this flash drive real quick. So
I better make sure everything is still in there. I think Warren forgot to hide the Party Buster folder. Not that I would open it, no matter how tempting. I have my self-respect.
All right, I'm out.
Now I feel too wiped out to leave.
Got a message. Oh, God. See you shortly. I hope so. I don't mind waiting here forever. I love this parking lot. I can count all the cars. The more I text, the longer I take on my way. Bye. All right, got the flashy flash. We up out. We on our way to the parking lot, though. Oh, my homie's gone. She's gone.
Fuck this shit.
Ow! That hurt.
Damn. I better rewind.
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
This action will have consequences. BT, by the way, thanks. We're not friends. Why are you texting me? What is your life about?
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
She's all like, by the way, thanks. I'm not your friend. You just texted me. I know we had each other's number.
Now that's what I call instant karma.
Instant karma.
Max, that was awesome. Thank you.
No problem. You have quick reflexes.
Years of mad dodging skills. Well, these never change.
That's why you're better off.
You're smart. We should hang out more. Now I have to finish this stupid book.
You finish that stupid book. What was your life about?
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
I could almost feel sorry for him if he wasn't such a serious dick. Poor Juliet. I always get a little giddy when I think about having my own room here.
Am I going to the main building? Apparently, obviously, I have to be going there because This must be where the parking lot is.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
You can't fool me. I know everything about this school. I cover the waterfront. So you better figure out what side you're on.
Please, leave me alone.
What if I would have intervened?
Hope you enjoyed the show. Thanks for nothing, Max.
I can't rewind. Let me rewind.
Man, I should have stepped in between Kate and David.
I just wanted to see if I could use that later on.
Over the line. I could rewind and try something different.
That's exactly what we're doing.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us. This is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Bitch ass, go away. Time for you.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate.
I have to like look at this at like a her perspective
like an
and stuff.
Hero helping Kate, but now Officer David Dickhead is after me. Maybe I should rewind and mind my own business.
Cause like I can use that later on for leverage, dude. Do I do the leverage option or do I? I want to have friends. I'm sorry. I want to have friends. I want everybody to like me. Everyone must like me, please. I'm out of Nas. It's not fair. Why do bad things happen to good people? All right, so we're back here. Front of everybody. At the main campus. Oh, it's a squirrel. Look at the squirrel. Unless you walk like that. Doesn't take that kind of motion to go down the damn stairs.
I'm glad I stepped steps. In that time. Can't stand to see people
how
being bullied.
Tori do that to me?
You're right.
Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
I won't bother you then. I have to go see Warren before he melts. See you.
Yeah, I'm sure we'll all be partying later with Zach and Victoria and the Vortex Club.
Yeah. Sure.
See you around, Max.
No, I want to. I like options. I like options, guys.
Hi, Juliet.
Skip.
Oh, hey, Max.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zach yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He usually does. Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
Better option. Tart, what?
I wonder how long before Samuel has to repaint that.
Mm-hmm. Bird! Take a picture of the bird. Aw. There's a truck.
Now this really pisses me off. So entitled. Sorry, handicapped folks. My truck needs these two spots more than you do.
Bastard. Take a picture. Take a picture! No one will care, will they? Damn, shit's on the car? Like, what? Stop.
Come on over here, please.
What's up?
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978 to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
60
You're
miles?
A long time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
You can draw?
You can draw? I thought you were blinded by science, not art.
Art is science. Music is math, etc., etc. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Hardcore. So you must use a computer to draw?
Of course. I'd love to tweak one of your selfies with some cool graphics.
That might not suck. I'll let you know.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
I've been busy.
No, I've been way too busy with class and life.
Damn, girl, you had it like a year.
Or a week. I did browse through all the titles, Drama Queen.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
No fucking way will I watch that. My mind is twisted enough.
I laughed my ass off.
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white. Plus, babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I need to talk. Don't want to speak about it. I need to talk. Let's talk.
I need to talk to somebody. Just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren. This is between you and me. Not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal, now.
I told him the truth. A student had a gun.
No, you told him I had a gun. That's why he dragged me into his office.
So? And did what? Give you a stern lecture?
Nobody. Nobody lectures me. Everyone tries, though. They try.
You should talk to somebody, Nathan.
Do not analyze me. I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh, man. You're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude.
Nice and headbutt.
Hey!
Super effective.
Nobody tells me what to do. Not my parents, not the principal, that. Or that whore
right
in the bathroom.
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Oh, bro, I got this.
Get in, Max.
Get your punk asses out of there now. Don't even try to run. Nobody.
No, let's rewind. I can't rewind. Aw.
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
No.
No, it felt like a real city for artists. Big and bright. Great for taking pictures.
Yeah, Must be hard coming back to a hick town like Arcadia again.
Not after seeing you.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Only for Mark Jefferson. He was a pretty famous photographer in the 90s. I've always loved his work.
Those that can't do, teach. I'm glad you found a good reason to come back.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
Give me a break, or I'm sorry. I like this, give me a break.
Give me a break. I was going through changes. Like you.
I guess those changes included dumping me from your life.
That's not true, Chloe.
Bullshit. You thought you hook up with all these art pricks in Seattle. Didn't happen, though.
You're merciless.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Why are you such a scumbag, though? You know we homies, right? Are you falling asleep? What are you doing? What's this nodding movement?
No. Man, are you cereal?
I'm not the only one that says that.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
Oh, made it. Oh, is this the end? I think this is the end. No? It's not. Junky ass truck.
Come on in. Don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
Home, shit, home. That's a nice house, and you call it home, shit, home. Okay. Okay. Nice room, though. I think. I don't know.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-führer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Oh, word. That's what we call that? That's what we calling it? Wait. Do you have, like... Oh, it's right here. No, it's... Yeah, look at it.
It won't play without any power.
Power strip! Too loud.
Now let's see what kind of music Chloe is into these days.
Those are pictures.
Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close.
Aw. It's not what I'm looking for, though. Where are the tunes, Chloe? Where are the tunes? Hello? Why are your tunes like nowhere near your Or is it plugged into the laptop? Probably not.
Now, let's see what kind of music Chloe is into these days.
Let's go to the laptop. Fuck it.
She looks super happy. She looks super sad. She looks super stoned.
Next one, she looks super sad. Ha!
I think this junk swallowed her discs.
Okay.
So it was Chloe who printed all those flyers.
I don't know where the discs are. Scratch my shoulder thing. Yeah, there we go. Too bad that's that Chloe Amber chick, though. Amber, whatever. I don't know what her name is.
Hey, give me that.
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
Hey.
Love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
And uh-huh. Have you heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Am I going to be rewinding back to 6 months ago to save her life? This is going to happen? I don't know. Let's find out. Let's put this damn CD in, though. Oh, shit. It was one already in there because I didn't put this one in here. You're feeling sorry for yourself, damn it.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
I see. Let me talk to you anyway.
My step-ass keeps tools down in the garage. I bet you can find something to fix your camera.
All right, fine. Still out the window.
We used to dare each other to climb down, but never did. This postcard is from Rachel Amber.
Search the drawer because I'm a scumbag of a friend.
We had such a blast drawing these together.
Already searched all those, looked at the TV. Well, I didn't look at the TV yet, but...
Hey, that TV used to be in the living room. Damn, Chloe does need a lot of money to get out of Arcadia.
3,000 buckaroonies. Step ass.
You can't go home again, said Thomas Wolfe. But here I am.
You gave me too many options, man.
Have not been touched since the last decade. I see why. Nothing's changed, except for me and Chloe.
I'm all up in your house, though.
This must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today.